right, speaking of weekend plans, something really special is happening this weekend. For 25 years, The Whale, it's been a beloved bar on Fort Myers Beach. And like many businesses and homes on Estero Island, it was completely destroyed when Hurricane Ian swept through. But today, it's starting a new chapter. It's time for the groundbreaking event for The Whale. And this celebration, it's happening all weekend long. I'm here with the owners, Mike and Don Miller, and Bob Taverini of the Taverini Foundation. Thanks for being here, guys.
Thank you.
Thanks for having us.
How exciting is it, this groundbreaking coming up? How does it feel to be hosting this weekend?
Well, you know, it's been a lot of work and hard work getting this to where it is today, with all of the builders and the contractors and getting everything put together, and especially with the architects.
Absolutely. What can people expect at the groundbreaking event? And then there are some events after groundbreaking at 1 p.m.
Yes. Ready?
Oh, so today we start at noon, and we go throughout the evening with live entertainment. We have live entertainment all weekend long, plus Dunk Tank. We're fundraising for Taverini Foundation as well as the Beach Kids Foundation.
Absolutely.
A lot of fun.
Yeah. Bob, how does it feel to be involved in this?
I can't even say enough about how excited I am about not only the weekend's event and the fundraising for the charities that we're going to be doing, but just the brand new Whale and everything that is going to be. It's going to be the new hot spot for live entertainment on Fort Myers Beach. It's going to be ground zero, I promise.
Absolutely. And is it? Are there a lot of new things at this rebuilt Whale, or is it? You know, have you kept the old touches that it used to have?
We're going to do some of the old touches on the first floor, but we're going to go three floors up. So, you know, the first floor will be more of an open concept with a bar entertainment there. Second floor will be all air-conditioned, soundproof for bands playing late at night. And the third floor will be overlooking the sunsets and open-air concept as well. And it's going to be a really nice building once it's built.
Wow, that's super exciting. And, you know, the drinks, too. Tell us a little bit about those.
Go right ahead.
It is Friday, after all.
Yeah, well, we're going to have some signature cocktails this weekend. But, of course, everybody loves to have a nice cocktail in hand while you're watching the sunset or even just looking over on the beach. So we have a fantastic view.
Well, you guys are beloved in the community, obviously. You know, have you had community members reaching out, or how does it feel to really be reconnecting with them?
I am so proud to be where we're at today. And I can tell you that our community is resilient, but they just, the outpouring of love they give us is amazing. So
yeah, how about for you?
The same for the most part. You know, we've got a lot of people that continually ask, you know, what they can do to help and things like that. And you know, one of the things with Bob is that, you know, he's just done a great job, and you know, we're going to actually be bringing him on board to handling all of our entertainment for the Whale.
Okay, that's super fun. Bob, can you tease a little bit of the entertainment for us?
Well, I can tell you that it is going to be it's going to be day-specific and then location-specific. We're going to have three stories of live music. So throughout the day, we're going to pick the very best option for that time of day to tell the story of the new Fort Myers Beach.
Yeah, absolutely. That's super fun. And this celebration, it's happening all weekend long, right? So that's awesome. What's happening on Sunday?
Go ahead.
Oh, well, Red Hannah's playing.
Yeah, Red Hannah.
Yeah, so our band will be playing. We're going to be the last band playing under the tent. And I just want to say real quickly how amazing it's been to have the option to play under the tent. Because when we first started doing shows at the Whale after the hurricane, we were literally playing off a generator and basically in a war zone.
Yeah.
I mean, it was seriously rubble anyway. So the amount of vision that they had to said, you know what, we know that it's not really going to be a money thing right now, but it's going to be a culture thing. So bringing live music back. Because what we would do is we would see our friends come over the beach crying tears of the beach we lost, and then the music would be the counterbalance. So the emotional value that it brought to, I guess, the levity of the seriousness of what we were facing, but it was also, it gave us some hope of what's going to be happening in the future going forward. So this is now, we're no longer at the starting line. We're now at like mile marker 10, and so we're cruising forward towards a beautiful destination.
Yeah, that's incredible. And for those who don't know, what does the Taverini Foundation help?
The Taverini Foundation, what we do is we provide musical instruments and lessons to kids in Southwest Florida that would like to play music but might not be able to without our assistance. So we just jump in and make sure that the money is never an issue.
That's fantastic. Very cool. Well, check it out. Groundbreaking. It's 12 p.m., you said?
Yeah.
And then they've got celebrations after that at 1. And congratulations again.
All right.
It's incredible.
Thank you very much.
Thank you.
Get down to the beach.